scared. Man, I'm just so passionate about life, about music.
Peace, everyone. This is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Seeker, and I'm doing this video because it's the end of the line for me. As far as the holiday is concerned, I have to go back to the J-O-B in the morning. But I want to say that, you know, all in all, I think that I had a restful period. I did a lot of creating, but I felt a little lonely. And it's purposefully that I did it, because generally I would go to someone's house, you know, for Thanksgiving dinner. I'd have to drive to Chicago, you know, and I just didn't feel like doing that this year, you know, this Thanksgiving. And I think the disappointment for me was that nobody called and said, we missed you, sorry you couldn't make it, you know, just calling to see that you okay. Nobody called. I was very, very disappointed and actually hurt by that, you know. But I realized that people are busy and that I am not at the top of people's lists, you know, and that I can't be forgotten. But it doesn't stop that bullet from trying to lodge itself into my heart. I'm just going to put that on record. I was very hurt. But I also, you know, realize that that is the way of the world today, and that we don't call each other or check up on each other or see about one another as we should, you know, particularly our loved ones, the people we say we love. When in reality, you know, love is manifested by the things that we do for one another. And, you know, as I've said before, I never require much, you know. But the fact that it didn't happen over this Thanksgiving holiday was kind of like an eye-opener, you know, to a reality that I kind of close my mind to. Every now and then, because you know what, it just seems like I'm expected to always be the one to make the move. And I think this year I just said I'm not doing it. And even though, you know, I'm not one, like I said, I'm not one that cooks or, you know, entertains people at my home and things like that, even though I've tried that before, I just decided this year that I wasn't going to be the one to take the trip, to make the drive to Chicago. And everybody knows I hate to drive anyway. But, you know, like I said, it was kind of sad for me, even though I think my niece texts me. And that's another thing, too. I think text has replaced actually talking to people on the phone. And it gives me an impression that, you know, when people text all the time, that they really don't want to hear your voice. You know, they really don't want to hear, because see, you could talk more than you can text. You know what I'm saying? So they really don't want to hear what you have to say outside of those little snippets that are done in a text. I find that real interesting that we've morphed into a society that types to each other all the time. We don't hear each other's voices or look in each other's eyes or anything like that. It's really sad, the state of humanity today. And so, you know, it just makes me think that even though I'm evolving and elevating, trying to elevate myself to a higher level of humanity, I constantly find myself slipping, you know, back to stinking thinking, you know, thoughts like, I don't even want to bring that, you know, bring that into the conversation, because those were negative thoughts, you know, that I had. And it was all the thoughts were definitely out of pain. You know, they were out of pain. And so I had to hurry up and shake it off. And I realized how easy it is for us to slip into what would be considered self-pity. And I'm not a person that's a self-pitier. I don't feel sorry for myself, you know. But I'm constantly in wonder about how others see me. Even though I, you know, how they see me is how they see me. But, you know, it makes me wonder, how do they really see me, you know? And I think a lot of times that's manifested in how people treat you, you know. But all in all, I must say that it was a very creative period for me. I made some really nice pieces, and I'm going to put up a video of some jewelry that I made over the Thanksgiving holiday. And I really was able to pour my creativity out. And, you know, all the symbols that I use, I reevaluated the meanings of all the symbols that I use in my jewelry and why those symbols are so important to me and why I want to spread them all around and have everybody wear them, because they have so much meaning. Our ancestors were very wise people as they tried to chart the human being to a higher level in their humanity with all of these meanings behind these symbols that they used. So that's basically why I use all these symbols in my jewelry. It's basically what they mean. It's not because they're popular. It's not because they're from a certain period of time and we hold that period high, but it's what the symbol actually means, you know, and what it's supposed to remind us of, you know. So I had a great time in the recreation of those symbols and the reevaluation of what they mean to me. And so I'm just going to share a few of them, and when I get time, I'll put them on my Etsy site for sale. If you feel as though you'd like to purchase some, they definitely would be there for your enjoyment and your pleasure. But, you know, this whole time I spent, it's in contemplation, and it's basically the doorway. I'm stepping over the door frame into a new year, you know, and so I'm preparing myself, hopefully for the better, in the new year to come, which is why I try to, you know, get rid of all that old stinking thinking and, you know, those old feelings of sadness and disappointment and, you know, all of those, and leave those behind and move forward in joy and peace in my life and know that I'm going to be okay, all right, at the end of the day. So I started this video with a song. And this song is done by my niece. Her name is Portia Marie. She's an up-and-coming artist. And I got this piece just by going through their Facebook and saw she put a link in there for my other niece. And I clicked on it and I was like, this is the shit for me. So as I close this video out, I will hope you like this piece by my niece. It's called Determined to Win. Because I am determined to win in this life that we call humanity. Don't know what the next is going to bring, but I definitely look forward to it. So with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Seeker. Peace, everybody. Yeah.
I'm just so passionate about life, about music, about love. Dreaming of better days, waiting past what I see. I'm looking for better ways to be a better me. Searching through the hurt and pain and past mistakes I made. I'm constantly trying to perfect this hand. I gotta play. And life sometimes is trite. The things you pick and choose. Be careful of what you want, cause it's what you gotta prove. That works, and if it don't, it's kinda like you lose or lost in what you thought was the best way and improve. It wasn't, and no, it doesn't help who and what you are. You stall in the process, making life just seem hard on a day-to-day basis. You gotta keep with the races and focusing on the path any situation you face. This world is not your friend, will devour you in the end. It's a day-to-day fight, this thing we call life. Call life. Day to day fighting this thing we call life. Call life. I'm a weirdo. 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 I'm a get there. Get there. Get there. We often view the world while living in the box. Looking at the box, telling us what to think. I was told, well, I thought this was the way to be. But in the end, wind up confused, being lost. With time paying cost, the world playing boss. With this heavy weight on me, was trying to lift it off. And at the same time, this life I deserve. And where I wanna be, calls softly. Like a breeze within the wind, it's brushing up against my skin. I'm motivated to win. Sometimes I ask why, who am I to reach the skies? Soaring high, above and not below. A poor outcast, aqua girl from the go. Why not? And so, I keep pressing forward. Staying true to me, with the blood of a slave, heart of a queen. I'm a weirdo, I'm a weirdo. 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 I'm a weirdo, I'm a weirdo.